patient. So our patient happens to be, how old?
7 months.
7 months old. It's really good when we have the mom, because the mom can help us. You get what I mean? Sometimes the parents aren't good to have in a room because they can't take what goes on. So there's a choice that you have to make. Do you want mom in, or do you want to call another phlebotomist to help you get through the procedure? You get what I mean by that? Okay. So, how you doing, sweetie? How you doing? Yeah. We want to try to make friends with the baby because we're going to have to do various things. It can't take us a long time because, you know, just like you, they get frustrated. So we're going to try to lay him down. It's very important not to have anything on this bed. Whatever you bring to this bed, you need to account for. You get what I mean? Because babies love to put things in their mouths, right? Okay, so I cut the tourniquet in half, and we're going to try to tie the tourniquet on and see if we can fill a vein on Camden. Yes. And you see how you got to hold his arm just like that. So, and usually, see how they twist? Very easy. So basically, this is just one phlebotomist holding. That's another mom or another phlebotomist doing that. Now I need somebody to feel and find and draw the blood. You get what I mean? If we're drawing a lot of blood, again, we would have to go in the arm to get that. If we're only drawing maybe like a CBC and doing a PKU or something of that nature, we're going to go in your foot. Look at him kicking me away already. So it's mandatory if we draw infants from the feet, from the heel, we have to warm that site up for 5 minutes. You warm that site for 5 minutes before you do the draw. Common sensely, why do you think we're doing that? Brings the capillaries up to the surface, making it easier to do the blood draw. So what we would do, let's say, you know, the proper ID, everything's been established. Now the interesting things about the ID, with the baby, you know, if the mom is there, it's on a requisition, it's going to have the mom's name as well as the infant's name. You understand what I mean by that? Mm-hmm. Okay, and if it's an inpatient baby, then again, they're going to have the ID band on as well. Outpatient, of course, would not. Okay? So I've done the ID. Now what I'm going to do is, again, oh, you want to sit up. It's been warmed for the 5 minutes, right? I still have to alcohol the site. All right? Now hopefully this is a good thing. He's being interactive. That's great. Now what I'm going to need to do is get my lancet, and I'm going to put it about right here. Brought the baby foot. Yes, you can see where you would have to poke a baby's heel. Do you see those two spots? That's where you would actually poke that baby's heel. So I'm going to do that. Hey, and Sharp's container. Very first thing I need to do is wipe the first drop away. I have to wipe the first drop away, and then I can do the collection. If it was on the PKU, you know, if it was doing a PKU, what I would be doing is I'm putting the strip, the blood droplets on this piece of paper. Yes, that's you. And mom, can you hold his hand for me? Thank you. So I'm going to squeeze like this. Squeeze. Blot. Squeeze. Blot. Squeeze. Get that good droplet going. Blot. Almost done. Okay, dude? Almost done. Blot. Yes. One more. Okay. One more. Here we go. Blot. All right. So I take my cotton and I cover the site. Okay? So that was just if I had the PKU. But if I still had other, you know, like tubes to draw or other tests, you can say. These are the microtainers we use for infant, you know, draws because it's less volume. Can you see that? Mm-hmm. And let's say that I had another test at this age, could be the bilirubin. You see how this is an amber color? Bilirubin we have to protect from light. So it's an amber color. So if I needed more blood, I wouldn't have stopped the, you know, gotten the cotton. I would have just kept on getting that blood droplet like this. You know, it's not easy, but it's possible.
Babies move a lot.
Yeah. Okay. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Almost done. He hasn't even cried or anything. You know what I'm saying? Okay. We're all done. Mom, hold baby for me. You know, because if I turn around, I don't want my father, you know. Then I would have to cap this off because it's an open top there. And this would be a top for the bilirubin. We want to invert it. Just like we do all the other tubes, right? Okay, and again, I have to take my labels. And just to show you, hold on one sec, excuse me. I'm gonna just run over on this side and get a label or two. So I have signed, timed, and dated the specimen. This one is going to go to the laboratory like this. Now you can understand, you get that. Otherwise, you could put it on the long way or, you know, all of that kind of stuff. Goes on just like this. And again, the mom's label, or the baby's label, I should say, because that's what I got. But go like that. I have to still sign off on my sheet, time, date, sign off on my requisition there. And again, you have to make sure, again, for infants, there's nothing that's left on. Mm-hmm. As far as bandaging, you never want to bandage a baby per se. So you really want them to, you know, keep it on until it's kind of sealed, not kind of, it's, you know, clotted off. And if that's the case, you have to bandage if anything. Small bandage and put the sock or whatever they have on the foot back on. Educate that mom to take that off as soon as they think it's safe and, you know, so forth. Okay? Thank you for making it a teachable moment.
Yeah, it's awesome.
We really, really appreciate it. Everybody get that? We might see Camden once or twice more before it's over with and we can do some more things. Okay?